迄日即个平安，今日是六月初六，是六月份头一个周日。感谢上帝，咱有通搁一摆奉主的名，三甲聚集来敬拜上帝，来侍奉上帝，互咱大家安静伫即个所你的厝内，陪伴你的心，用心灵诚实，三甲来敬拜咱的上帝。咱搁一摆来到主的头前，做一个开始的祈祷。Bow head for the word of prayer。上帝君，感谢你，因为你是听君的上帝。你将你读书家主要说赐予君，为君定立十字架里面，借着你的宝血来洗净君的罪，和君查罪你的家里，今仔日有当来到你的头前来侍奉上帝，来敬拜上帝，一切都是因为你。唔是君有当来到你的头前，是你大神主动伫阮的中间做了奇妙的工作，所以君有当敬拜。主啊，帮助你的教会每一摆来到你的头前，将这个清洁的心、洁净的心来到你的头前，借着主耶稣基督宝血来洁净，和君无后无处来到你的头前，好来敬拜侍奉上帝，将教会交到主你里面，继续今日的聚会，君的敬拜，无论是君的祈祷。君所求的圣事，君所得的信息，来帮助君面对这个人生，特别在这个对照为主发出更严的作用，为上帝献出你家己荣耀，好人看到将荣耀归乎天顶的老爸。献出君的感谢，君将所录起敬拜的时间交到主你的手中，愿圣灵在君的中间向多人君来敬拜，愿上帝在君的中间享受一切的敬拜，因为你是配得。敬拜的上帝，感谢上帝，听君的祈祷，奉告主耶稣基督的圣名。Amen, Amen。下次别咱三个用心灵诚实来侍奉敬拜咱的上帝。God bless you。
Lift my praise to you, lift my hands, lift my worship to you, and I love you more than I can say. Oh, I love you more than I can say. Ever I will sing, only you will I adore, glorify.My Lord, only you will I serve, for the world will fade away. Still my song to you remains, only you will I adore. Praise to you, lift my hands, lift my worship to you, and I love you more than I can say. Oh, I love you more than I can say. Ever I will sing, only you. soul to you remains. Ever I will sing, only you will I adore. Glorify my Lord, only you will I serve. For the world will fade away, still my soul to you remains, only you will I adore. Only you will I adore. Only you will I
我要传扬他的爱。
你这边平安，你是个人，你陪伴咱的心，你阿叔煮的饼及煮的杯，且得按圣经话。在哥林多前书第十一章廿三到廿八节，圣经讲：我当日传道恁的，原是对主所领受，所以主耶稣并非一暗托起饼来，祝谢了就撇开讲：这是我的身躯，为你放杀，你就按呢行，为的是纪念我。饭后也常款托起杯来讲：这个杯是用我血所立的新约，你特别念的时就按呢行，为的是纪念我。你特别食这个饼，念这个杯，是表明主的死直等到以来。所以无论什么人，若无按你食主的饼，念主的杯，就是干犯主的心及主的血咯。所以人应该家己省察，然后食这个饼，念这个杯。这段圣经是保罗写给教会，教导咱照人领受主的饼及主的杯。主要说，并非一暗将这个圣餐来设立。伊将这个饼劈开，将伊葡萄汁倒出。主耶稣讲：这个饼是代表我的身躯，这个葡萄汁是代表我的血。这个饼劈开，这个葡萄汁倒出，是代表主耶稣的十字架为咱的罪，将身躯劈开，将宝血流出来洗净咱的罪。但系圣经及人讲，人应当家己省察，然后食这个饼，念这个杯。所以你做圣餐的人，需要家己好来祈祷，好来省察家己，避免这个心来领受主恩的饼及主的杯。咱时刻安静地坐位里面，好来祈祷，求上帝灵来省察咱，避免咱的心来领受主今日好咱的饼及主的杯。咱大家来抽一个圣诗，比如咱的心内耶稣做会饼及做会杯，咱唱咱的圣餐的歌，省察家己。咱大家来唱。
当我们走到神的面前。默默审查自己，回想以往的年日里，蒙了多少恩典。主啊，主啊，我亏欠了你，我真亏欠了你。求主赦免我罪过，怜悯我们。有多少时间奉献给你，专为自己而求？再多少思想亏欠了主，养生的担忧。主啊，主啊，我亏欠了你，我真亏欠了你。求主赦免我罪过，怜悯我们。如今我愿意悔改谦卑，求主承认我心中，愿将一生献给。
全基督是用，主啊主啊，哥感谢你，我要感谢你，因为你已赦免我们，拯救我。
咱这个人也是做饼甲做杯 ，put the bread and the cup together。咱再甲做一个感恩的祈祷。天父，阮感谢你，你听咱，将你独生子主耶稣赐予咱。为阮的罪钉在十字架内面，将你的身躯劈开，主将宝血流出，来洗净阮的罪，医治阮一切的亏欠，让阮在做上帝你的儿女。今仔日有通领受你的饼入你的杯，让你的生命提醒咱已经在咱的内面。保罗讲：现在活着不再是我。乃是基督在我里面的活着，让我们因为主的生命的原因，让我们一生为主来活。特别我们感谢你，祝我今天在你的头前领受饼和杯的旨意，管我们每一个人，我们的身躯，我们的灵，我们的魂，拢都蒙主你家己的保守，完全无通指跌，直到主耶稣第二摆对天顶过来。愿上帝祝福你，赐恩给你。祈祷奉靠主耶稣基督的圣名， Amen。 愿上帝祝福你的姊妹， Amen。 你的姊妹平安，
Peace to you brothers and sisters in Christ。
我们继续思想智慧人生的蓝图，这个系列的信息。
We'll continue the sermon series Blueprint for a Life of Wisdom。
今天来看传道书第九章。
This morning, we'll be looking at the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 9.
智慧人生的困境。
The perplexity of a life of wisdom.
人生真多叫做 uncertainties.
There are so many uncertainties in man's life.
咱智慧人就去面对。
And how can a wise man face these uncertainties?
在圣经里面有三卷的册叫做智慧的册。
There are three books that are called Book of Wisdom.The first one, Book of Proverbs.
箴言的重点是教导咱怎样建立人和人美好的关系。
How can we have a good interpersonal relationships with other?
所以箴言是教导咱所谓叫做情商 emotional quotient.
The Book of Proverbs will teach us emotional quotient.
另外一个叫约伯记。
Another book, the Book of Job.
约伯记是教导咱用智慧来去面对苦难。
How can we face life's sufferings or challenges with wisdom? How do you face unexpected questions or problems? And it's an adversity quotient. The third book, the book of Ecclesiastes, and how can we face the very short and very uncertain life with wisdom. Many things that will happen in our life is not within our control. That's why the book of Ecclesiastes can be considered a book on UQ. What is UQ?
It's uncertainty quotient.
Uncertainty quotient. Many things that will happen in our life are beyond our control. How do we face this? And being a wise person, King Solomon provided five very important principles. And this is the truth found in Ecclesiastes chapter 9. The first one, submit to God's sovereignty. Second, cherish your life.
第三,
and third,
就享受你的生命,
to enjoy your life.
第四,
fourth,
就掠掉现今的机会,
seize the present opportunity.
第五,
and fifth,
就看重上帝永恒的赏赐,
value God's eternal reward.
用这个环境来面对人生叫做 uncertainty 的代志。
We face life's uncertainty with these five principles.
头先,
first,We need to learn how to submit to God's sovereignty. Verses
1
to
3.
Let's look at verse 1.
我将这样代志放在心顶，详细考究就知呀。义人及智慧人，伊并伊的作为，拢在上帝的手中。啊是听，啊是分，拢在伊的头前，人无法知呀。
So.I reflected on all this and concluded that the righteous and the wise and what they do are in God's hands. But no one knows whether love or hate awaits them. King Solomon, showed us very clearly. No man will know what's going to happen in front of his life.That's why we lead an uncertain life. And this is a very good explanation. There is one sure thing in this world, and that there is no such thing as sure thing. Nothing in this life will be sure. Even if you look at the book of James, chapter 4, verses
13
to
14.
Now listen, you who say today or tomorrow we will go to this or that city,Spend a year there, carry on business, and make money. Why do not even know what will happen tomorrow? What is your life? You are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes. In the past one and a half year,As we experience this COVID pandemic, and deeply we experience and understood that there are so many uncertainties in one's life. Doesn't mean to say what you want to do, you can do it.
顶年四个吹过，渣渣是恁个教会 discipleship center 的奉献的日子。
Last April 5th last year, it was supposed to be the dedication service of our church discipleship center.
恁个车贴已经搬出去了。
All the invitations were sent.
恁个讲完车了了。
Even the main speaker was invited.
但是恁无法强强需要暂停。
And yet we are forced to postpone this.Event. I believe that. Personally, or even at your workplace, there are so many plans in your life, or your company's plan has to be suspended or cancelled. Because many things are not within our control. And how should we face this? Let's read James chapter 4, verse 15.
你就按你讲，主哪关意，恁能获得，恁有通创这样代志，还是那样代志
？Instead, you ought to say, if it is the Lord's will, we will live and do this or do that.
主哪关意
？If it is the Lord's will.
这第一关键，这个 main keyword， 这第一重要的代志。
It's the main keyword. It's the crucial point.
不是个爱什么就做什么。
And not what you want to do.You will do it.
是上帝主管啊。
It's God's sovereignty.
所罗门讲。
That's why King Solomon said.
无论那是义人还是智慧人。
Whether you're righteous or a wise person.
你一切代志在上帝手中间。
Everything in your life is in God's hand.
但是在你的头前是听是恨。
However, before you, whether it's love or hatred.
咱唔知呀。
We do not know.
忽然间，你和别人听这个人听你。
suddenly somebody else loved you.
还是忽然间，何人受气呢
？Or people hated you or got angry.
你唔知因为什么
？And you don't know the reason.
好嘅朋友忽然间同你冤家。
Good friend suddenly quarreled with you.
出来人忽然间变面对，就做你嘅仇人，你嘅敌人。
Your family members suddenly changed their face and becomes your enemy.
你根本唔知啊
！You don't even know.
因为冇在你及超嘅掌管嘅中间。
Because all these things are not within your control.
但是
，However，
在全能嘅上帝超嘅中间。
They are in the hands of our Almighty and Sovereign God.
那唔知呀，唔是讲上帝唔知呀。
It doesn't mean to say if you do not know, God does not know.
那唔知呀，2022年早嘅发生这个 pandemic COVID-19 嘅代志。
We could not expect that early last year in January, this COVID pandemic exploded.
到今日，到今日都未解决。
And up to this day, it is not yet solved.
但是你唔知呀，我唔知呀，唔是上帝唔知呀。
Even if you do not know, I do not know, it doesn't mean to say that God does not know.
一切在伊的掌管的中间。
Everything is within His control.
所以第二到第三节。
And that's why verses 2 and 3.
凡临到正人的代志，拢是上管；异人甲歹人拄到代志，是上管的代志。好人、洁净人、无洁净人、献祭人、无献祭人，拢是上管。
All share a common destiny, the righteous and the wicked, the good and the bad, the clean and the unclean, those who offer sacrifices and those who do not.
好人就有罪人也是同款，乞食就有假乞食人也是同款。
As it is with the good, so with the sinful. As it is with those who take oaths, so with those who are afraid to take them.
第二讲之下所得到一切的代志。只有这样代志，这个祸患就是正人所拄到的，拢是同款。
This is the evil in everything that happens under the sun. The same destiny overtakes all.
你拿大汉文的圣经
，If you read the Chinese translation in the Bible，
这三段的圣经里面有这个字，一摆一摆出来，叫做同款、同款、同款、同款。
And you'll find that on three different occasions in these two verses。The word the same appeared three times.
拢是个人拄到代志，拢是同款。
Everything that you encounter in life, they're all but the same.
伊讲，是个人的心拢充满了罪恶，活着个信心来狂妄，后来拢归伫死人这个所在去。
The hearts of people, moreover, are full of evil, and there is madness in their hearts while they live, and afterward.They join the dead.
拢种人到上一个所在去。
Because all men will end up in with the same destination.
这两节、这三节的圣经。
And in these three verses,
提供各款的人。
It provided us with five different types of people.
异人、歹人。
The righteous and the wicked.
好人、罪人。
The good and the bad.
洁净的跟无洁净的。
Clean and unclean.
献祭的跟无献祭的。
Those who offer sacrifices and those who do not.
意思是讲有宗教嘅，还是无宗教嘅
？Which means that those who believe in a religion or those who believe in something and those who
don't. 乞食还是假啊？乞食。
Those who take oaths and those who are afraid to take them.
拢种人都得上这样代志。
All of them will face the same result.
什么代志
？And what is that?
就是 eventually 拢种归伫死人嘅里面。
Eventually, all of them will meet each other under the category the dead.
冇这个人能避免这样代志。
And no one.Could escape this.
所以《团道书》第三章第二节讲生无死，死无死。
And that's why in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, a time for birth and a time to die.
所以求主帮助人。
So may the Lord help us.
一切在上帝掌管的中间。
Everything in life is under God's control.
面对人生这种 uncertainty,
even as we face the uncertainties in our lives.
那唔知呀。
Though we do not know,
不是上帝不知道
it doesn't mean that God doesn't know.
那就顺服上帝的主权
We need to obey and submit to His sovereignty.
好了，第二个环节
The second principle.
在这个真正 uncertainty 的人生的中间
In this uncertain life that we live in,
我们要挑选这现在我们的生命
We need to learn how to cherish our present life.
你看第四到第六节
Verses 4 to 6. Anyone who is among the living has hope.Even a live dog is better off than a dead lion. For the living know that they will die, but the dead know nothing. They have no further reward, and even their name is forgotten. Their love, their hate, and their jealousy have long since vanished. Never again will they have a part in anything that happens under the sun. These three verses taught us how to cherish, how to love our lives. Even if we live in a short and temporal life, even in the end, we need to face death. But a living dog is far better than a dead lion. It's a very commonly stated saying during the time of Solomon. Because the lion is considered the king of all beasts. And a lion is such a ferocious and powerful animal. And the dog pertaining here is not just the wild dog that you see outside. And these are the valueless dog. In comparison, comparing a valueless dog to a powerful and ferocious lion. And King Solomon said that it's better for a live dog than a dead lion. Because after one's death, you have nothing. In the same manner, after a man dies, he will be insensitive. He will not know anything. There's no reward. And no one remembers them. Be it their love, their hatred, even their jealousies will all vanish. King Solomon reminded us how to cherish and how to treasure our present life. For life is very precious. Even if there are so much difficulties and hardship in one's life, as if there's something undependable, so many difficult and trying circumstances, but each life is valuable and precious. Do you know what's the last portion in the book of Jonah?
The last word.
The last word. And if you look at Jonah chapter 4, verse 11,
this is 上帝跟Jonah讲的一句话,
the what God responded to Jonah.
你说这个利利米的大侠, 其中没分辨多久早久啊, 有12万的人啊, 还有很多生畜, 我怕没听说吗?
Should I not be concerned for the great city of Nineveh, in which there are more than 120,000 people who cannot tell their right hand from their left hand, and also many animals? Oftentimes, we refer to children as those who do not know or who could not differentiate their right and their left hand. And God truly loved this 120,000 children. And not only that, God also loved the many animals within the city. In short, God values life. For life came or emanated from God. And that's why in Psalm 116, verse
15,
precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saint. Because of
COVID-19,
we are aware that many passed away from this world, including those who belong to God. But please remember, in the eyesight of the Lord, precious is the death of his saint. And recently, as I began my study again of the book of Job, because after this sermon series is over, I'll share with you from the book of Job. Towards the concluding part of that book, in chapter 42, Job
郎中是家己所失去物件的 double 两倍。
And God has blessed Job two times, things that he has lost before.
只是家里无 double。
It's only his own children was not double.
伊失去了十个家里。
Job lost 10 of his children. But in the end, God blessed him with another 10 children. God did not give Job 20 children. Some theologians explained that. Job had already 10 children in heaven and 10 children at that time on earth. That's why it was counted as double. Personally, I'm not against this explanation.
但是请你注意,
but please pay attention.
失去永远是失去。
A loss is a loss.
你失去一个囝。
If you lost a child,
后来上帝给你两个囝。
And God has blessed you with two more,
请你记得。
Please remember.
你永远记得失去这个囝。
You will always remember the child that you lost.
因为生命是无法用另外一个生命来代替。
And because it's not possible to replace one's life with another life. When I was still a child, one time I saw my mother gazing out the window. At that time, it was already late in the evening, about 11 o'clock. My older brother has not yet returned home. And I could sense that my mom was so anxious because it's getting late. So I told and reassured my mother, Mom, it's all right. Because even if older brother will not return, you still have me. And my mom was so angry at me. Because at that time, I was not I'm unaware. And now I understand. Every life in the eyes of a parent is very important. That's why life is precious. We need to cherish and treasure our time in our life. As we live in a very uncertain world, let us live each day properly. The third principle, not only should we enjoy our life, we also need to learn how to enjoy our life. And in verses 7 to 10, these four verses taught us how to enjoy our life. Christians often have this wrong understanding, thinking that all Christians should do every day is to pray, to fast, and to read the Bible. To attend meetings. The clothes that you're supposed to wear is either black or white. And your food should be the plain and the simplest meal. You need to drive the cheapest car. Otherwise, you'll be accused of loving the world. Let me tell you. Loving the world is not an issue of one's heart, but it's about the material things.
No, like that, like that.
Loving the world is an it's not an issue of the heart.
No, it's not the issue of the material thing, but issue of your heart.
Yeah. It's the issue of the heart. If your heart has issue, then you'll definitely love the world. Even if you consume the simplest meal, even if you drive the lowest value vehicle, in your heart, if you love the world, then you love the world. That's why as Christians, we should not love the world. We need to enjoy the world that God has created. And we are familiar with the Westminster's Confession. The first question asks,
上帝为什么创造人？
Why God created man?
伊个答案真简单。
The answer is very simple.
为了荣耀上帝，享受上帝。
To glorify God and to enjoy Him forever.
所以基督徒乃咪就享受上帝啊。
As Christians, how can we enjoy God?
他讲
First,
享受生活中间的灵食。
We enjoy the food and the drink in our life.
第七节
In verse 7.
你只管欢欢喜喜去吃你的饭，心中欢喜饮你的酒，因为上帝已经接纳你的作为了。
Go, eat your food with gladness and drink your wine with a joyful heart, for God has already approved what you do.
当你欢欢喜吃你的饭，饮你的酒。
Every day, with a joyful heart, you take your food and drink your wine.
享受上帝的物质里面给你的祝福。
Enjoy the material blessings that God has given you.
Yeah, 中国人讲，吃就是福。
And the Chinese has a saying, if you have something to eat, then you are blessed.
当然，咱不是叫你逐日多吃多啉啦。
Of course, we do not mean that you can feast and eat to your heart's content every day.
对你的身体也是不好啦。
It may not be healthful for your health.
但是呢，有当好享受上帝给咱的食物。
ButAs long as you can enjoy the good food that God has provided you. Second,
享受生活中间的情趣啊。
Enjoy the pleasures in your life.
你看第八节。
Let's read verse 8.
你的衫要常常洁白，你的头唔当沾酒膏油啊。
Always be clothed in white and always anoint your head with oil.
那不是叫你逐日穿第贵的衫。
Doesn't mean to say that you wear the most expensive signature clothes.
不是逐日用珍贵的香水啊。
Nor should you use expensive perfumes.
意思讲我你唔通过一个真肮脏的生活啊。
It only simply reminded us not to lead an untidy or unclean life.
也最近因为这个 COVID-19 的原因。
And nowadays, especially.Due to COVID-19,
也做人不出门
and many avoid going out.
但是你的家来，你唔能少个随便。
Even if you're at home, you should not be careless.
特别咱做姊妹
especially sisters.
你唔能在你心头心面啊。
Your hairdo should not be untidy.
唔能过你头一个小裤，一个小裤底下啦，吓死人。
You should not be with your rollers and your makeups.
那时候叫做 presentable.
You need to be presentable.
好人看到。
So that when others see us,
当然兄弟也是同款。
Of course, it goes the same with the brothers.
好享受你的生活。
Let us enjoy our lives.
第三。
Third,
享受家庭中间的温暖的生活。
You should enjoy the warmth of your home.
你看第九节。
Let's read verse 9.
在你一生呼吸的日子里面，就是上帝所立的日光之下，呼吸的日子中间，及你所听的太太快活度日，因为这是你的生前在日光之下劳碌的代志所得的份。
Enjoy life with your wife, whom you love, all the days of this meaningless life that God has given you under the sun.All your meaningless days. For this is your lot in life and in your toilsome labor under the sun.
甲你的妻子，甲你的丈夫，甲你的儿女，甲你的父母，好好生活就一个。
Live a wonderful life with your spouses, with your parents, and with your children.
唔当过你冤家。
You should never quarrel all day long.
啊，做代志唔免输个高价。
You need not to be very detailed in many things.
免过你甲你出来工人冤家。
And you should not argue or quarrel with your house helps.
唔当早起起来就骂这个骂这个骂工人骂看守骂家里。
And you should not scold your spouse, your helpers, or your children from early in the morning.
安尼我的家庭真可怕。
So it's a dreadful family.
特别现今我咧，大家咧无出门啊。
Especially if we avoided going home, going out nowadays.
难免及出来人有真侪个侪conflict 嘅时阵。
It's inevitable that it will provide more opportunities for conflict at home.
出来人无一个真正水嘅气氛啊。
Unless there's a very good atmosphere at home.
人会笑咧啦。
People will go crazy.
So, 求主帮助咱。
May God help us.
好啦，第四方面。
In verse in 14.
享受工作顶面的成果。
We are reminded to enjoy the fruit of our labor.
第十节。
In verse 10.
凡你手所创的代志，都尽力去做，因为你所创的，因为你这个起的阴间，无工作，无谋算，无知识，无智慧。
Whatever your hand finds to do, Do it with all your might, for in the realm of the dead where you are going, there is neither working nor planning nor knowledge nor wisdom. And you should find joy in what your hands do today. If you only work for wealth, then it's a pitiful profession. I'm a pastor. My most important task is to share God's word so that brothers and sisters could understand in a clear manner. From March 2020 until today,
到今天,
up to this day, for a continuous 15 months' time, I am preaching the word of God to you each and every Sunday. This does not include fellowships or other Bible study meetings. I do to the best of my ability to prepare adequately and to preach with clarity. Because I have this desire in my heart. Before I retire, I will leave behind a sermon series to the church. For example, the book of Malachi. If you do not know what the book of Malachi is telling, if you listen to these four chapters or four messages in the book of Malachi, I'm sure that you will have a better and correct understanding of the book of Malachi. May God help us. It doesn't matter what your job is, but let us do to the best of our ability. Especially if we still have the chance or opportunity to serve our God. The fourth principle, in the midst of this uncertain world, we should learn how to seize the present opportunity. Verses 11 and 12, I have seen something else under the sun. The race is not to the swift or the battle to the strong, nor does the food come to the wise or wealth to the brilliant or favor to the learned, but time and chance happen to them all. In this verse, especially those of you who read the Chinese version, you'll find that five different times it mentioned not to this or not to this or to this or to that. And in this uncertain world, even if you have some qualification or if you have some beneficial requirement, and yet it will not guarantee your success. Look at this. The race will not go to the swift. As a child, we're familiar with the story of the tortoise and the hare. And during that race between the tortoise and the hare, of course, the faster running rabbit will win. But in the end, it's a tortoise who won. If you're a fast runner, it will not guarantee you will win the race. And secondly, in the same way, the battle will not necessarily go to the strong. The story of Samson, which we are very familiar.
Samson is the Superman.
And Samson was considered the Superman in the book of Judges. No one could physically overcome him. But in the end, a strong and powerful Samson, his eyes were dug out. Third, the same way the food will not go to the wise. The wisest man in the Bible is King Solomon. Are you familiar with the story of King Solomon?
神啊，受到第一智慧王，后尾竟然甲伊伊个太太伊个伊个妃妃嫔哦去杀个敬拜偶像。
Nobody could expect that this wise king, King Solomon, at the last portion of his life, he worshipped idols with his concubines.
结果上帝受气。
And it caused God to be angry at him.
有伊个国家一个变做两个。
His nation was divided from one to two.
所以哦，失去了一半个。
And half of his wealth was lost.
够什么呢？
What else?
伊讲第四项，明节的无嘟嘟嘟的积财。
The fourth principle, favor will not go to the learned.
你知影这个阿希多菲的故事不？
Or the wealth is not to the brilliant, Ahithophel story.
这个人哦，
this man
是大卫的时代第一有智慧的人。
Ahithophel was the wisest man during King David's time.
圣经讲啊，
and it was described in the Bible.
人求问这个人，亲自求问上帝。
The Bible described that people who inquire Ahithophel seems to be inquiring from God.
这个人真真聪明。
This man was so intelligent.
但是这个人后来帮阵阿撒龙来对付大卫。
And later on, Ahithophel helped or counseled Absalom.Against David. Because this man was mad at David.
You know why?
Recently.
Because he was grandfather.
Ahithophel turned out to be the grandfather of Bathsheba. And because he was mad at David. And because David murdered Bathsheba's wife and had Bathsheba as his wife. In the end,
上帝将这个人第一智慧人的计谋，无要让人接受，无让人适应。
And God caused people to disregard the counsel of Ahithophel.
结果这个人都去自杀死去。
And in the end, Ahithophel went home and hanged himself.
如何讲
？Finally,
伊讲明朝的无得到得到夸喜。
Favor is not to the learned.
所罗门的故事你知影不
？Are you familiar with the story of
Absalom?
Absalom.
Absalom 是真真聪明的人。
Absalom was considered to be an intelligent person.
你来好读圣经。
If read the Bible carefully,
这个人真真搞哦，叫做收买人心啊。
Absalom was very clever man, and he stole the hearts of people.
用现在话来解释。
In today's language,
这个人的叫做 public relationship 真好啊。
This person has a very high public relations skill.
一看到人就勒到人的手。
Whenever he will meet somebody, he will hold his hand.
Oh, 你好，你好，你好。
And greet him warmly.
圣经讲我众人的心都归乎伊。
And the Bible described that people's hearts were stolen.
结果伊拿罪，伊得不得到人的心，得到人的夸喜了。
He thought he already had the support and the favor of people.
结果叫来反伊老爸。
When he rebelled against his father.
结果呢？
In the end,
死在战争的里面。
He died in battle.
Solomon 在讲什么？你知道吗？
But Solomon was telling us.
伊讲 ，Solomon 讲所念够正人的，拢在乎当时的机会。
Time and the chance happen to them all.
你有真正有好的条件。
Even if you possess the best qualification.
好的条件，无嘟嘟有通帮助你成功。
Your good qualification will not necessarily help you to succeed in life.
最重要就是当时的机会。
The most important thing is the opportunity and the chance during that time.
你得抓住当时的 opportunity.
You need to hold on to the opportunity at that time.
第十二节。
In verse 12,
你讲关于人唔知影家己的定期。
It turned out that no one will know when their hour will come.
这个Hour will come 是讲到你的死的日子什么时候临到
？It pertains to the time of your death。
就进入什么呢
？It's comparable to。
喜和梦啊，掠着；焦和梦啊，掠着；祸患忽然间临到，死的人陷在其中，也是安尼。
As fish are caught in a cruel net, or birds are taken in a snare, so people are trapped by evil times that fall unexpectedly upon them.
你讲人啊，唔知家己的定期哦，你离开世界的时阵，什么时候发生
？For people or man will not know when is their end time or the final hour of their lives.
天就起，唔知什么时候好梦掠去。
Just like fish, they are not aware when they'll be caught in a cruel net. Or the birds do not know when they'll be taken in a snare. In the same way, we who are in this world, suddenly we're faced with unexpected problems. And the only thing that we're aware of is to take advantage or make the best use of the opportunities God has provided us. Winston Churchill gave this very famous quote. A pessimist sees the difficulty in every opportunity, and an optimist sees the opportunity in every difficulty.
So,
what kind of a person are you?
你是看到機會還是看到困難?
Do you see opportunities or do you see difficulties?
另外更加重要的事情,
more important than this,
你需要備辦好,
you need to be prepared.
你的備辦了,
after preparing,
機會來,
when the opportunity presents itself, you can get hold of this opportunity to work for God. And this is a very nice saying.
他說不是人人都有通為家己
It is not often that a man can make opportunities for himself, but he can put himself in such shape that when or if the opportunities come, he is ready.
So, 有人说成功是好几关已经备办好的人.
Success is to those who are prepared. May God help us. As we live in these uncertain times, even if we do not know what will happen to us in the future, but let us prepare properly. Let us prepare for opportunities that lie ahead. The fifth principle. We should value God's eternal rewards. Verses 13-18. In reality, this verses 13 to 16 is a story. And you know what's this story all about? In a small city, a very weak city, it was attacked by a great king. And in that city, there was a poor wise man. This man had no money. Neither does this man have power. But he has wisdom. And with his wisdom, he was able to save the whole city. But in the end, no one remembered this poor wise man. That's why King Solomon said, wisdom is far superior than strength. However, no one will remember. No one listened to his counsel. What King Solomon meant here was, in this uncertain life that we live in, please remember, your hard work, your diligence may not guarantee you success. Your wisdom, your intelligence, your wise counsel, your contribution may not be remembered by people.
为什么呢?
Why?
十八节,
in verse
18, 他说,地位也给拍剑的兵器, 但这个罪人有当败坏真最好的事情。
In verse 18, wisdom is better than weapons of war, but one sinner destroys much good. As we live in a sinful world, many things will not be clear as black and white. Where good may not necessarily be rewarded, or evil may not necessarily be punished. Even if you do something extremely good, you will not necessarily get reward. Neither will you be praised or commended. Do you know what is our question? That's the way it is. After I've done this thing, I expect people to praise me, to commend me for my love for God or for good things I've done. How hardworking, how much effort you put into this, that the entire church, you are the best. But maybe you'll not be remembered. You'll not be praised. And you'll not be commended. In the end, oftentimes you end up complaining. You'll be disappointed. And you will give up. May I ask, do you find such things happening in your life? It's happening everywhere. In society, in churches, in your families. How much hard work, how hardworking am I as a father or as a mother? And these children, they do not know how to appreciate. Useless child. Oftentimes, we responded directly. Yet, we should acknowledge that we lived in a sinful world. And nothing will happen in accordance to what you think it will happen. So you ask this question, how do we face this? Because of the sinful world that we live in. Some people might be jealous. And they will put you down with force. As a Christian, of course, we hope that we will be respected. We hope that we will be praised. More important than this, you should long for God's comment and praise. When the Lord will say to you,
"Well done, good and faithful servant."
Don't you think that is the best commendation? Psalm 90:17. It's one of my most favorite verses. May the favor of the Lord our God rest on us. Establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, establish the work of our hands. When God will establish your work, when God remembered what you've done,
前面,
may I ask, is there anything more valuable than this? May God help us. As we face these uncertain times of the world, that we do not know what will happen before us. Please remember these five principles.
Number one,
first, submit to God's sovereignty.
Number two,
second, cherish our lives.
Number three,
third, enjoy the life that God has given us. Seize present opportunity. Value God's eternal rewards. May God talk to you directly.
Let's pray.
感謝上帝, we thank God that in this uncertain world that we live in, as we do not know how to face, but God, you provided us with answers. May the Lord help us. As we seize and take hold of these five important principles that God has given us, even as we live in a short and temporal life, in this uncertain life that we live in, help us to lead a wise life. We thank God. Continue to help us. Help us to understand the details of this blueprint of a wisdom-filled life. Please continue to speak to each one of us. And we pray this in the holy name of our Lord Jesus Christ and Savior.
Amen.
Amen. Brothers and sisters, next time we'll share with you Ecclesiastes chapter 10. And as we await what King Solomon wants to share with us, see you again next week. May the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Amen.